It is too late. Turn back now. Return to whatever loved ones you still cherish, and perhaps you will evade Korvaak's wrath. Do you not see? If not for my actions, humanity would already be doomed. Korvaak may be a bane upon this world, but he is also our only hope against the darkness that's already consuming Cairn. The Eldritch Sun is our salvation, not the false gods you serve. You do not know. The very gods you chose to serve are nothing more than lies. The three are not true gods, merely usurpers who will get their just rewards. Korvaak is humanity's only hope against K'thon and the legions of the Void. I did what I had to. Humanity already lost this war. We require the aid of a greater power. A power that seeks the destruction of K'thonians above all else. Some deaths are inevitable. A small price to pay for the survival of our people.
Skill's not ready.
You disappoint me, Kymon.
Give you a good price on what I've got left. Iron well spent.
Thank you. Korvaak's anguished cries have echoed across realities. I'm afraid I do not know. I presume he had to do something on behalf of Dreek himself.
Who am I to question the will of the gods? Who are you to question them?
His cult has been crushed. Even now, his scattered followers are being hunted down and eliminated. The forgotten god will soon be a distant memory. Without a vessel, his powers will wane, and he shall fade into nothingness. Never again will the people of Cairn have to fear for their lives at the mercy of Korvaak's fickle temper and destructive malevolence. Know that the witch gods are grateful for your sacrifice, even if they do not thank you in person. Wherever your journey leads next, their eyes will be upon you. Here, a prize from the gods themselves.
We must ensure that none of Korvaak's followers survive what happened here. If belief in Korvaak persists, then a spark of his being shall remain. We must snuff it out while we can. Korvaak will never again be a threat of the magnitude we faced this day. That I promise you. Without a vessel to contain his primordial form, his powers will wane. And should he ever hope to return to Cairn, the witch gods will see to his demise. But if he is truly forgotten, do not think to believe the snake tongue of that being. It spreads naught but lies. The Eldritch Realm is the domain of the three, now and forever. Let us just say that I was once a young priest in the service of men here, believing myself righteous, but my eyes were opened by the witch gods. When they forged their covenant, I offered myself in service. My actions saw the cults flourish beneath the Empire's gaze. For my accomplishments, I serve unto eternity.
See anything you like? See you around.
Welcome back, my friend. Back so soon.
With Draelis's eye turned elsewhere, it falls upon us to dissolve the claws digging into our minds. Though the Mind Reaper lies dead, its spirit lingered. One of our honored seers had recently succumbed to illness. We knew not its nature, and none of our remedies alleviated the symptoms. Hers was a disease of the mind, not of body. Ishtal had struck our ranks one final time. Inara's mortal flesh now bears two souls. Hers and that of the Mind Reaper. The loss of a seer as gifted as her would be a grave one, but we cannot allow Korvaak's fiend to endure this horrid act unharmed. We have peeled back the curtain of her tapestry, and found that Inara was headed to the tomb of Nephos within the Valley of the Chosen. What the Mind Reaper seeks there is clouded to us, but it must not be allowed to pass. Take this hex stone. It will ward you from Inara's curses. She was one of Drake's favored, and is with Draelis, one of our honored.
Come see what's left of my wares. See you around.